My name is Marta Urriols. I live in Barcelona, and I've published three books so far. The first one is called L'anatomia de les distàncies curtes. The second one is Aprendre a parlar amb les plantes. And the last one, which came last October, is Dolça introducció al caos. One of the ideas of the book is that death is something unique. The experience of losing someone is something unique, but at the same time, the feeling is really universal, you know? So it's nice to see that what you can explain here, it touches also readers from somewhere else. You linger like something unresolved. That's how the energy feels. Like those endless to-do lists you always made. Lists of things we never found the moment for, remember? Organize the photo files, set up autopay for the parking garage, buy varnish to restore the table out on the terrace, call the repairman about the noise from the extractor fan. On the same list, I rack up rebukes I'll never voice to you, only to myself. And I suppose it must be normal, this pressure on my heart, filled with griefness and tears. When hating you doesn't work and I really want to weep, I use the muscles in my neck to hold back the tears, to keep myself from succumbing to a mood appropriate to my double tragedy. I go over each and every one of the neck muscles in a soft voice until I've managed to turn you into a cold anatomy poster, gradually distancing myself. Sternothyroid, sternoidoid, sternocleidomastoid, I repeat in a relentless string, but you always come back with your glasses on and the list of things to be done in one hand. From bed, I look out at the neglected terrace. All the plants have steadily died. How did you do it, Mauro? It must not have been enough just to water them. You talk to them, not openly, never in front of other people. You said that talking to plants was a private transformative act. An act of faith for those who doesn't believe in miracles. I get up, take a breath, and add to my list, learn to talk to plants.